This is Japan's electrical outlet. And if you visit, you'll see it everywhere. At the airport, McDonald's, your hotel. But something is missing. What happened to the third hole? Ground. You might have been told it stops this from happening. Better luck next time, Marv. That's why ground is required in every other country. Italy, Australia, China, Russia, Afghanistan. Shockingly, Japan still allows this outlet to be installed in new buildings today. This got me curious. Is this safe? What do they know that we don't? So I did a deep dive into electrical systems and wired up a Japanese panel so I can show you two things. One, why many people, including me, were wrong on how they think grounding works. Two, Japan is the opposite of America. They drive on the left, they read from the right, their last names come first, and their electrical safety systems work in reverse of ours. Thanks to that, two holes are better than three. Let's find out the secrets of Nippon. This video is sponsored by Delete Me. More on them later. Before we can talk about how this could be better, we need to understand what grounding actually does. Scene, you're about to make toast. You should never get shocked by an appliance. And if you do, something has gone horribly wrong. Let's open this up and see what happened. Huh, look there. The insulation was damaged and electricity leaked out. So when I touched it, I got zapped. We need an emergency backup. Ground. It's the round pin, and this could have stopped me from getting shocked earlier. We follow this. This goes into our case, and of course, it wasn't connected. Let's fix that. So we fixed the connection from our ground to our metal section here, and from here to the back to that metal section that shocked me earlier. Now everything is joined together to the ground pin, which goes to through your outlet, down this copper cable, which eventually attaches to a grounding bar inside your electrical panel. And this shoots outside to a grounding rod that's buried several feet into the earth below. This forms our emergency circuit that is commonly called ground. Many people think that when electricity leaks out, ground brings this into the earth. This is wrong. Instead, let me show you how we actually save your life. We turn off the power. Ta-da! Let's go see where. And we do it at your electrical panel by tripping the circuit breaker. Can't get shocked if there's no electricity. Now, so your circuit breaker can trip really slowly, minutes, if you got too many appliances turned on. These can also trip really fast, 0.05 seconds. Less than a blink of an eye. And we do it by sending a huge jolt of energy into it, and ground makes that happen. Here's how. We create a connection between ground and neutral. This forms a high-speed raceway for electricity from our appliance back to the transformer outside. We need this because a regular circuit is like a narrow and winding pipe, limiting current. This is how your 7-watt light bulbs stay 7 watts. But a ground circuit is one big straight pipe, very low resistance that lets a ton of energy through, way more than a 15 amp breaker will allow. So when energy leaks into our toaster, it discovers this huge, wonderful pipe and rushes in. Bring the fam. Power surges and your circuit breaker then freaks out and trips in a split second, cutting off power automatically. There are a bunch of ways to connect ground with neutral. We can attach a wire, we can put them all on the same bar. And this energy highway is how ground stops shocks and fires at homes, at least in North America. Let's talk about how you could stop another threat to your safety. Your personal information being bought and sold online by organizations called data brokers. That's where Delete Me, the sponsor of today's video, can help. Data brokers are a big reason you can end up bombarded by ads that know a bit too much about you. In the worst cases, you're targeted for blackmail. Last month, a scammer emailed my father with his full name, home address, and was threatening they would release scandalous videos they recorded of him.
I'm glad he asked for my advice, but he could have just given in and sent over money. Delete Me can help prevent these invasions of your privacy and safety. And in just a few clicks, I give them permission to go out and make legal requests to hundreds of data brokers to remove any personal information they have on me. Delete Me gave me a report which listed who they contacted and how many have completed this request. What would take weeks of frustrating research and emailing is done with a few keystrokes. If gaining control over your privacy and safety is important to you, check out Delete Me. Get 20% off consumer plans using the link joindeleteme.com/lamb and use promo code lamb. Link in the description. There's also a family plan, which means I can protect the people around me, including my father. Let's get back to our story and talk about what's going on in Japan and why can't I get this outlet?
Japan is known for being safety focused. So the government even has PSAs on tracking fires, which is when dust accumulates in the plug, conducts electricity, and flames shoot out everywhere. So what gives? Turns out Japan has these outlets because 50 years ago, they went the reverse of every other country to make these safe. They were forced to. Grounding doesn't work very well in Japan, thanks to their uncommon infrastructure. To understand why, let's take a look at a Japanese electrical panel. And if I take off the cover, this block is where ground cables are inserted. But unlike America, it's not connected to neutral. It only attaches to the grounding rod outside. This is called TT earthing, and it's used in Japan, France, and only a few other countries. If electricity leaks out, the only way for it to get back home is through the soil, up a pole to the transformer. This has high resistance, and just like a tiny pipe, it can't pass enough energy to trip the breaker unless soil conditions are perfect, so you could still get electrocuted. By the way, the Japanese can't be like, oh, let me just attach a wire from ground to the neutral and just call it a day. You also need to upgrade infrastructures like substations and overhead wiring as well. That's expensive and takes a long time. So the government did something faster and arguably safer. Starting in 1971, Japan was the first country to protect all home outlets by putting one of these in their electrical panel. It's a GFCI. Ground Fault Circuit Interrupter, also known as RCD in Europe. Here's what it does.
A GFCI monitors how much current is coming in and out. Normally, this should be identical, but when you get shocked, you absorb some of the energy and the return current is reduced. The GFCI senses this and it trips, turning off the electricity to the circuit. And it does this really fast, less than 30 milliseconds and under 30 milliamps of current. This is in the safe zone, but it's really going to hurt.
GFCIs like these are the gold standard for protection, as they stop shocks that grounding can't, like touching hot wires directly. In North America, we put these in the most dangerous locations, like the bathroom and kitchen, because water and electricity, bad. The problem with that is that only some locations are protected. That's why Japan placed the GFCI in their electrical panel to protect all their outlets at once. This panel is made by Panasonic, and it has a pretty common layout for Japan. Main breaker is here. GFCI, and this monitors all the individual outlets to the right. If I unplug them, you can see how a metal bus bar connects everything together. With this panel, ungrounded outlets in Japan can be safer than the American versions without GFCI. And why? These ones are still allowed today. I tried to find home electrocution stats for Japan, and I only found this 2010 report by Kansai Power saying no death accident in general households. All right, video over, right? Not so fast, because Japan requires this contraption. It looks like a regular outlet, but if you take a peek underneath, we have this. Weird. I'll need a screwdriver. And now for our special cable. And I'm gonna wedge this connection under here. Screw it in. Close the door. Plug her in. This is a Japanese grounded outlet. But before you hit the dislike button, I never said these didn't exist. Yes, I'm blaming you. Hold your sassy comments though.
These are rare, and as a tourist, you'll never see one unless you look at the back of a washing machine or an air conditioner. But what do we need grounded outlets in Japan for? You would get shocked before the GFCI activates, and that's up to like 30 milliamps, which could injure or kill small children. And if you got heart problems, good luck. Ground replaces your body and automatically sends the electricity away, tripping the GFCI for you. All right, let's see this in action. I have a resistor in my hand, and I'm gonna stick this between hot and ground to simulate what happened when electricity leaked in our toaster. By the way, this is dangerous. Don't do this at home. It worked. The energy was safely sent away and the circuit turned off, stopping anything from injuring you. Grounded outlets and GFCI are like apple pie and ice cream, two best friends working together. In Japan, putting it ground wasn't that important, so they took their sweet time, and it was only in 2022 that these outlets were required in kitchens, washrooms, and the outdoors. If we look back at our video from Tokyo Portfolio, you can see these grounded outlets I conveniently left out. Japan is actually pushing for these outlets to be installed because they're far more convenient to use. But like all safety upgrades, it's gonna be a while. Like these grounded outlets are gonna be everywhere, and they're gonna be the norm. In America, GFCIs are added to ground. Japan is the opposite, and they added grounding to GFCI. We can argue who has the better system, but if there's anything I learned, is that GFCIs are superheroes, and there are two things you can do to keep it that way. One, check your outlets with a tester. Not only does this detect wiring faults, but with a button press, this should trip the GFCI. If it doesn't, it's broken, replace it. At the very least, use the test feature. Number two, think about replacing these if they're older than 10 to 15 years old. The mechanicals inside can break and they'll be missing a self-test feature that automatically checks if the circuit is working and disables the outlet if it doesn't. I'll have more information, sources for this video, and links to products in the description below. There's also a newsletter I send whenever I release a new video with some behind the scenes stuff. Finally, check out Delete Me if you want to improve your privacy and safety. Use my link below to get 20% off. Now, this video is over.